How to add a background color to text in Affinity Photo, PC or Mac. Select the text in Affinity Photo, then go to the View menu, Studio and Character. You can now see the panel here. And you can see here, you've got the red, and that's the fill color, and also you've got the background color here. So just click there, and then just change it. So maybe go for blue or black, etc. You just run through the colors and change it to your heart's content. If you decide you don't want the color, suddenly you think, you know what? I don't want purple, I don't want anything. Just click here. Unfortunately, you can't select gradients. That would be great. Go to the tools panel and select the artistic text tool. You can select one or two or three characters. Then go to the character panel and click here in the background color and set it to black or green, etc. With the artistic text tool selected, go and select another character, go up to the character panel and click background color and set it to a different color, maybe blue or black. Select the other character or however many characters you've got and change the color to green. If you made a mistake and you decide I don't want blue as the background, go to the character panel, click here and change it to maybe green or yellow. If you don't want any color, just click here. Just a little nil and then it's no color at all. If you change a color and you decide you want to undo, you may find you need to do two or three undos to get back to the original color. You'll notice that the size of this rectangle is slightly bigger than the size of the text. How to get it exactly matching the size of the text? Well, you have to use a rectangle. Please put in the comments below if you know of another way of doing this. Go to the tools panel and select the rectangle tool. Create a rectangle slightly bigger than the text. Select the text. Go to edit and cut. Then select this rectangle. And then go to edit and paste inside. Select the text in the layers panel and you can move it around. Position it, resize it. You can also select the rectangle. So select that. And then you can resize this. However, notice when I resize that, it shrinks. You can just squeeze it up and down. That's not what I want. What you need to do is go up here. With the parent or the rectangle selected, go to lock children. Set that to on. Now you can resize it. You can reposition this. Just move that out of the way a bit. Reposition that. And you can see as you do that, you then will get the text exactly cut off in the way that I want it, which is like that. So exactly. However, of course, you've still got some text that's slightly taller, obviously because of the D there. You can also then deselect this again and then just resize it, move it around and all those sort of things. You can rotate it and much, much more. Maybe you decide you want to change the text. Well, go here and select the word in the layers panel, then go to the artistic text tool, select that, and then go here and maybe select, say the O and type A, and it's changed. If you change the lettering, suddenly the text may be slightly shorter, and you'll see that, or longer even perhaps, and then you need to change it here. So just go over here and change it. However, you'll notice because I'm doing that, it squeezes. I don't want that. Again, go to lock children, make certain that's clicked, and then you can resize this. And again, just put it so it matches there or there, exactly in the way that you want it. And again, you can always deselect that once you're finished. Maybe you want to manipulate it further. Well, you can do that by converting it. So this rectangle, I don't want the rectangle. However, select the text first and then go to edit and cut, or use the shortcuts, of course. Remove the rectangle, don't need that anymore, and then go to edit and paste. And now you've got your text. If you want to change the text, change it now, because now I'm just going to convert it to curves. Just go here, convert to curves, or maybe right click and convert to curves, either. Once you've done the convert to curves, unfortunately the order of the layers is not particularly what I want. However, you can fix that very quickly. Simply just go here, select the curve, and drag up to, say, the D, drag that one up to the R, and that one to the A, and that one up to the W. Now, I've got another one here. Now, this one is just the line, obviously slightly made a mistake. You can always just remove that. That's a bit of the underlying rectangle. If you want to, you can group these. So you can select the D and the green, just select those, and then right click and group. You don't have to do that, but it just makes it easier to manipulate sometimes. You can now select the characters in the layers panel and move them around. Maybe select that one, and move that there. Select that one, and move that there. And so on. However, if you want to resize this one, say the green, you want them to be actually matching the character, what you need to do is select here, select the curve, and then resize it, and just drag it down to, again, snap like that, just snaps it there, notice there, and then there. Whoops, a bit far. So you can do that for all of the other characters. You can now select the characters and then move them around or rotate them or scale them. You don't have to keep them the same size. You can reposition them. Maybe select this one and then just drag that over there and select that one and drag it over there. So you can create all kinds of text touch-up designs. Go to the Layers panel, select the D, go down to Effects and click 3D and add a radius and close. Select the W or any of the other letters, go to Filters and then Blur and Gaussian Blur, just to blur the text. Click Apply. Select the character and the background and drag up the group and reposition it. Once you've done that, you can resize and then you can go to Blend Modes. Go over here, maybe Darken, Multiply, Color, Lighten, etc. Once you're happy with the design, go to the group and then go to Layer and Rasterize. And rasterize the whole design into a pixel layer, if that's what you want. You can then apply filter effects and much, much more. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Thank you much.